Greetings, I'm Mr. Spiffy, and welcome to the bottom of the barrel. Normally, I don't do this. I don't tend to do a running review of a show while I'm watching it. But in this particular case, this night's Monday Night Raw is going to deserve it. As we start off with a really... something that they haven't done much of since the early 90s. It's something they really should avoid doing. And that's pro wrestler singing. Oh my god.
It was silly.
It was silly, but it was awful. At least they weren't completely tone deaf. You know, the last real tone deaf one I heard was Bret the Hitman Hart. Man, a great wrestler can't sing worth shit. We actually got to see Jack Swagger on screen for a whole 1.5 seconds, so apparently he still works there. Congratulations to him. We have Santa Claus coming out to give gifts, and then Santa got run over by Del Rio. Matter of fact, I said that literally seconds before it happened, as I knew he was standing over the Del Rio area where the car was coming out, and someone had put out a spoiler, unfortunately, on a board without... we tell them not to, but they put out a spoiler on it saying that Del Rio attacked... they said Del Rio attacked Santa. Now, I just sort of threw out a joke on it and got it, and I wasn't expecting it to be right. We have Kane versus Cody Rhodes already happened. Match was mediocre. Two things I can say about it. One, supposedly, Kane has some sort of special relationship with Santa. I don't want to know. Considering Kane's special relationship with some of the other things that has happened over the years, maybe it's for the best none of us know. Also, I wouldn't have mentioned this match at all except for when Kane went for the clothesline, the King had to say, "He's like a Christmas creature out there!" Yeah, and if you don't understand the joke, Glenn Jacobs came... his very first gimmick was a Christmas gimmick in WCW known as the Christmas Creature, where he was effectively a wrestling Christmas tree. Finding footage of it is high near impossible, and pictures as well, because it was literally a one-shot thing that happened in like 1993-94. Most people don't even remember it. But it happened. And so, yeah. We're at commercial break. If there's more things worth talking about on Raw, I will bring it to you here. Right, something else I forgot to mention. I muted it. It's the Santa's Helper Divas tag team match. Whoopity-doo. There was also a backstage segment where Del Rio looked really upset, and everyone was standing around the trainer's room hoping that Santa's okay. And John Cena came out and acted... let's say he just chewed the plaster off the walls, and Santa's last words before slipping into unconsciousness was, "There's going to be a Miracle on 34th Street fight between Alberto Del Rio and John Cena." Joy and rapture. Oh, look, it's Natty in her outfit that doesn't match anybody else's. Because, it's pink hearts. Wait! That's not a Christmas outfit! That thing is clearly like a Valentine's Day dress! It's just got the fringe on it so it's Christmassy, but it's got hearts all over it. You know, I know she's a heart, I understand, but it looks more like something that you would have for Valentine's Day. Anyway, I'm sure this match is boring, but the rest of the Divas have gotten a little better, so maybe it'll be worth watching. You know what's pretty sad is when the TV commercial is more entertaining than the match that was on right before it. I mentioned the Divas tag match. The audience was dead. Half the audience was like this. And the Divas on the apron trying to get them to get behind the match was more. The big thing for at the end of this whole thing, okay, so Caitlyn keeps winning over Eve when it doesn't really count. A commercial for the new WWE Dictionary updated thing. In WWE Encyclopedia. Now completely purged of Chris Benoit, I'm sure. Also, they just had a commercial for Axe Shampoo where the guy's dandruff was making women disintegrate. Remember, dandruff kills. The Lumberjack Frost match is starting, as you can kind of hear in the background there. Let's I'm going to throw out a prediction here. This match is going to end in a schmoz with all the Lumberjack Frosts getting into a big fight. That's my prediction. Let's see what comes out of it. Told you so. That was, I fell asleep during that matchup. I did get up early this morning to get, take Spiffy Kitty to work, but yeah, I kind of dozed off during that matchup, so. Yeah. That Christmas hat? That Santa hat barely fit Albert's head, or Tensai's head. He was like, eat, sitting there. That was the first thing to fall off of him. Yeah. But, all in all, whatever. If there's anything more to talk about, I'm sure there'll be plenty of more stupid Christmassy stuff in here. Oh yeah, and Big Show started singing Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer in a real horrible voice at Sheamus in the match. I got that part of it. Definitely the worst of their series. I hope that this battle is over for now. So Brad Maddox, in order to get a contract, has to be one of Santa's elves. If he starts singing, "We are Santa's elves," I'm going to bang my head against a wall. These AJ Ziggler segments are brutal. I mean, absolutely brutal. Yes, 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 Alberto Del Rio ran over Santa. I know, we've seen it. They have a heart monitor on it. How much we want to bet that at some point that heart monitor for him is going to go, and Alberto Del Rio fucking kills Santa Claus. This Raw is giving me a headache. It's got its good moments, but and some funny moments. But overall, it's a pain in my neck. I only have two words to say. Merry Christmas! Merry Christmas! Alright, Happy New Year. Kali, he causes me great pain. And am I the only one who's really bored with Brad Maddox not actually getting a contract at this point? Seriously, I've seen the guy wrestle in FCW. He actually has some skill. And the fact that they aren't doing anything with him and this little pathetic attempt of him constantly trying to get a contract sucks. It for straight up sucks. Let's not make any bones about that. And it's going nowhere. Give the guy a contract. Or pack him back off to NXT. I don't give a fuck, but I'm just tired of it. So Punk comes out and makes fun of Great Khali as well. I'm all for that. And he runs down Ryback, runs down the injustices and about himself being the WWE champion. Typical shtick for what's going on currently. Ryback comes out and announces that the match on the first Monday of the new year will be TLC match. The match they were originally supposed to have. So the WWE is still going to get the match they should have paid for, but they got the Shield instead, and that match was fucking awesome. Hopefully this match lives up to the awaited hype, considering, you know, the weight behind it. And, you know, I'm looking forward to it. That's definitely going to be a good ratings boost, at least in my opinion, for Monday Night Raw, the first Raw of the year. If not, you know, can't say, you know, then that doesn't say much for Punk's reign, you know, because they've been trying. They've been really trying. But we obviously know, I'm pretty sure he's not going to lose it, you know, because they're still planning on Rock versus Punk, so we'll see where it goes from here. Okay. So Santa's heart monitor now plays Jingle Bells. And Santa is tapping his feet together and going, "There's no place like home. Get me the fuck off this show. Get me the fuck off this show. Please, God, anywhere but here. I'd rather be back on NoDQ.com doing the Q&A in a really dumb version of the show than doing this. Just anywhere but here. Anywhere but Raw. Anywhere but Raw." Sorry, Aaron, I couldn't help but take a little hit at you. All right, time to sum up. First of all, there was a lot of really silly stuff that happened on the show. There were a couple of decent moments. Probably, I think the best was Miz and Kofi teaming against Antonio and Wade Barrett. That was probably the best match on the card. That and Daniel Bryan versus Damian Sandow. Both of those were quality matches. Other than that, everything else was very campy, very Christmassy. I could have done without the 600,000 puns from Jerry Lawler and Michael Cole. Figured out pretty much from the ho-ho-hos at the beginning that Santa was Mick Foley. And, of course, so the surprise at the end was Santa doing the mandible claw on Alberto Del Rio. Hardly surprising. The stuff with, like I said earlier, the stuff with AJ and Dolph Ziggler, absolutely brutal. And the ending bit was just terrible. I was just waiting for someone to say, "There's a branch in my ass!" Or, you know, like, "Ow! That's... what's poking me in the side?" And when they fell over on the Christmas tree, so I mean, on the Christmas tree. Trust me, I've just gone under a Christmas tree just to string lights and stuff like that. I wouldn't want to fuck on a Christmas tree! Honestly! Ouch! This Monday Night Raw was definitely... I wouldn't say it was the worst Raw ever, because certainly it wasn't boring. It managed to entertain, but certainly it lacked heavily on quality wrestling. The Miracle on 34th Street fight match was silly. A couple things I did enjoy about it. Throwing the teddy bear. I'm just glad the teddy bear survived. Nobody killed the teddy bear, that was fine. We had a couple harkens back to the classic hardcore matches, including the bowling ball to the nuts, which I always wondered how they did that one safely, because I was like, that's a ballsy thing to do, all pun intended, I suppose. And, ow. It just, overall, the entirety of the show, it was definitely more entertaining than the Christmas stuff, but they wasted a perfectly good pumpkin pie, and that would upset my wife probably more than anything else, because, you know, we both love pumpkin pie. And when they use food on there, it's usually just, it's pie is whipped cream. And that's it. And, you know, nothing like that. So, pumpkin pie wasted. You know, that kind of sucks. The upside to this show. No Sin Cara, no Rey Mysterio, no Randy Orton. Overall, 3 out of the 4 people I don't give a fuck about weren't there. So, kudos on that. The 12 Days of Christmas tag match, I barely paid attention to it. I decided I was going to reorganize my trading cards instead because, well, that's more entertaining geek adventure. I only kind of caught it out of the corner of my eye. And generally, as I came to about the last hour and a half of Raw, I kind of gave up on it and just sort of half-assed watched it. Kane and Daniel Bryan backstage exchanging gifts. That was funny. That was good because he gave Bryan his Slammy Award, and then he goes to give Kane a puppy dog, and Kane was like, "Thanks! I was hungry!" Classic. And all it really needed, if it had been a Chihuahua, that would have been a perfect notion back to the whole Big Boss Man, Al Snow, Pepper gimmick, which...
I think it was a Chihuahua.
No, that
long-haired
dog...
Long-haired Chihuahua.
They have a long-haired Chihuahuas?
I would have to go back and look at it again. I'm pretty sure it's a long-haired Chihuahua. It is a true breed.
Huh. Oh, no, I've never seen a long-haired Chihuahua.
I watch dog shows. Used to.
Yeah. Anyway, you look at it, Daniel Bryan saved it from becoming pepper steak. And, yeah, overall, entertaining show, not anything I would watch again. I'm Mr. Spiffy, and the Sparrows would scrape clean. As a Christmas bonus, I'm not sure if I'm doing it tonight or tomorrow, depending on how I feel. I've already got it finalized, edited, and rendered. I will be presenting to you SmackDown, Shut Your Mouth, CAW. A project that took me somewhere in the extent of 6.5 hours to make. For a record-setting 1 hour and 7 minute long video. So hopefully you'll enjoy it and sit through that. And tell me your comments below on what you thought of Monday Night Raw. I'm just shaking my head. All I can say is this was just plain silly.
Right, stop that! Silly!